अज़बिल्लाह मिन शैतान रजीम, बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर बुक टू पार्ट वन, एंड द फर्स्ट एसे और द फर्स्ट लेसन इज द डाइंग सन। डाइंग सन एक्चुअली हैज बीन एक्सट्रैक्टेड और टेकन फ्रॉम सर जेम्स जीन्स बुक द मिस्टीरियस यूनिवर्स। The lesson is based, dear students, on the theme or the topic creation of our earth and the beginning of life on the earth. Sir James Jin says in his book The Mysterious Universe that our first feeling about the universe is that of fear. In the very beginning of the lesson, he tells that stars are so big that hundreds and thousands of Earth can be packed in each side of a star and still a room to spare. It means the total area of our Earth, and it may be multiplied by 100,000 times. And a star will be big enough to keep it. And then he tells about the total number of stars in the universe. He is of the opinion that it may be equal to the all grains of sand on the seashore of the world. Keep in mind, dear students, Sir James Jones was a great mathematician, great teacher of physics and great astronomer. But this lesson is based on speculation. It has not been calculated scientifically, but still the facts and figures described in this lesson are near to reality. Next he tells that these uncountable almost stars are traveling in space. He supposes that if we take a scale model, suppose an ocean is a scale model and there are ships in it, and the distance between two ships is 1 million mile. अगर दोनों के दरमियान जो है फासला 10 लाख मील का है तो इट इज़ वेरी वेरी रेयर दैट वन स्टार कम नियर टू द अदर। बट ही इज ऑफ द ओपिनियन दैट अ रेयर इवेंट टुक प्लेस इन द यूनिवर्स एंड इट वॉज ऑलमोस्ट 2000 मिलियन ईयर अगो दैट वांडिंग स्टार इन स्पेस हैपन टू कम नियर our star, that is sun. And as the other star came near our sun, it created disturbance on the surface of the sun, as moon and sun create disturbance in our ocean almost 2 times in 24 hours. As our star and the other star were of great masses, the mountain formed on the surface of the sun was unimaginable. But as the other star came nearer and nearer the sun, the mountain or the disturbance or the rose higher and higher due to their great pull. And ultimately, before the other star receded, it came back. That mountain on the surface of the sun was torn to pieces. They were thrown into the space. They call it planets, or we may call that is our planetary system. So James is of the opinion that when planets were thrown off the sun, they were part of sun and they were very warm. He says that we call the stars that are the big burning balls of fire. But when our planetary system was created, these planets are called solid mass, and no, they have their have no heat or light of their own. Sir James Jane says, we don't know when, how, and why life started on Earth. However, we can say that life started on Earth in simple organisms. And these simple organisms may be one cell and organism. They have the capacity to reproduce themselves before dying. This was a series of life, and ultimately human beings were born. And we all know that we human beings have ambitions, we have sense of beauty, and we have religion, we have aspirations. And this is one way that life started on Earth. Then he discusses that if we think about the whole universe, our first feeling is about fear. Why it is frightening? It is frightening because the space is so large, so vast, that it is unimaginable. The span of time, the stretches of time, we can't count it. When was the first cell or the first organism created, and how many thousand million years it took to change into life? And then he says, the necessary condition for life were only found on our Earth planet. And the most important was temperature. And they called it the moderate temperature. We need the moderate temperature. If we have a glass of water and it is in our room on the table, it remains in the liquid state. When this condition was available on Earth, the life started. No doubt, there was air and water also necessary for life. Is there any life in the universe? There may be, but the possibility is only the temperature belts. It says temperature belt means the areas where the temperature is neither too hot nor too cold. Because if anything went inside that temperature belt, it would be burned up. And if it went outside that temperature belt, it will be frozen. It means it is a speculated essay, but well written, full of information and facts. No, being an English teacher and you being a student of language, this is how can we write an essay. This is an essay. If we want to write on any topic, we must keep in mind it's all pros and cons and write it out in a proper way. Dear student, what I needed on your part, please spare some time for your studies. Time is precious. Don't waste it. Pray for all. Thank you very much.